Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kapke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes, we go over another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D. Today's 3D modeling tool is Weld. We'll go through all of the settings and hotkeys for the Weld tool while creating this fox mask. My goal is to make a mask that looks a lot like origami, that looks like it's made out of paper. We have an example here. If I turn on Start IPR, you can see it begin to render. You'll notice that I actually removed the Phong tag from the fox so that we can really see that low poly style and we don't have any shading in between the polygons. If you're interested in learning about the Phong tag and all of the Phong related 3D modeling tools, you can check that out in the link in the description. As I go through the tools for this 3D modeling tutorial, if I mention a tool, I will leave it in the description, the tutorial for that exact tool. This tutorial is focusing on Weld and not going into depth of the other tools we'll be using, but I'll leave links to other tutorials that I've made relating to them so that you can know more about them if you're interested in learning more. I'm going to turn off the IPR. Going to start a new project by hitting that plus arrow there. I'll drop in a plane. I'll turn on my lines. The hotkey for that is NB, or you can click here under display. I'm going to change the width and the height to about 200. I'll zoom in here a little bit. The width segments are higher than what they need to be, so I'll take these down to about 4. I'll take down our height segments to 1, and this is the start of our mask. I can make this editable by hitting this button here or by using the C hotkey. It'll change our parametric primitive plane to being a editable object. It's hard to say that, parametric primitive plane. That's what it is though. Okay, we're going to make this editable by hitting the C hotkey. Now you can see that our plane has this triangle next to it showing that it is editable. With that done, we can grab some points in here to show how this works. I have my selection brush here and I will select these points along here. Now that I've done that, I can activate the Weld tool and we're going to give this fox a nose. The hotkey for it is MQ for Weld. So if I click right here at the Weld tool, you'll see all of our points go there. I'm going to hit undo with Control Z. That's Command Z on Mac. And I actually want to weld this to the center here. So I'm going to click here. Now we have the beginning of our nose. I'm going to use the E button in order to move this welded point up. And you can see that that really is one point that we've welded together. It was 4 and now it's 1. We don't usually want to make triangles 3D modeling, but this is the exception for it when you're removing the Phong tag and you want something to look low poly. This is the exception for using it. There's times to break 3D modeling rules, and this is the time to break this one. I can actually just delete this tag over here. And now we also need to make ears over here. So we'll use the Weld tool for that. So the first way that I showed you can use the Weld tool is by selecting the points first. The second way is that you can use it without any points selected. And then there's two hotkeys you can use, Control and Shift. I'm going to show how both of those work with these points here. So I'll use MQ in order to bring up our tool again without any points selected. And we'll hold Control and select this point and drag it over here. I think I need to zoom in a little bit to see what I'm doing. I'll drag it over here and you'll see a line from the first point to the second point, and both points are highlighted white. I'll let go and you'll see that we have just welded the first point to the second point. And that's what happens with Control. If I hit undo with Control Z or Command Z on a Mac, if I hold down Shift and weld these two points together, you'll see that they actually snap in the center. In this case, I'd actually like them to have one snap to the other using the Control. So I'm going to hit undo and we'll just do this again over here, holding Control. I'll do it on the other side, holding Control. And that's the beginning of having two ears. Now, in order to make these ears, we need to select this point here with our brush tool and bring this on down. Now it's becoming the shape of our fox. You'll notice that we still need to add eyes and some details to the ears. So I'll hit the middle mouse button to come into our four quadrant views, and I'll hit the middle mouse button again in our top view. I'll zoom in here and I'm going to use the line cut tool using MK, and I'll drag my mouse across here, holding Shift. Shift activates quantize so that we are snapping to this angle here to get a straight line, and I'll let go and hit Escape. Now that we've created that cut there, we have a very nice beginning shape for the nose. Now we'll need to do the same thing for the eyes. I'd like the eyes to go here. I'm holding down Shift again, and I'll hit Escape. We can also do this for up here for the ears and make those cuts there. If you would like these ears to be a little bit bigger, you can of course change the shape of this to whatever you would like. For right now, I think maybe I will do that. Maybe I will make these ears a little bit bigger. I know I shouldn't be tweaking this so much. I'll move this down just a little bit there, and I'll use MK again to cut it a little bit lower to get the shape we're going for. Now with that done, I can hit the middle mouse button again and come out of that view. I can come in here and I can select these two ears. I can use the MW tool to bring up our inset tool that we've gone over previously, and I can click and drag my mouse with preserve group selected here in order to inset these. I want the inner ears to be moved down, so now I'll use the Y arrow to move these down. We have some nice fox ears now. We also need to create some eyes. So I'll go ahead and select these. I'll use MW again, and I'll hit apply and apply our previous settings here to create an eye. This actually looks kind of small to me. Maybe I'll make it a little bit bigger. So I'll hit undo and I'll click and drag and make the eyes more like that. And then I can do the same thing on this side with those same settings by hitting apply. I'll apply the previous settings to the second group of polygons. Now with both of these done, I can hit the T hotkey and drag these in. If I hold Shift, I can utilize quantize again and snap to different amounts. So I'll have this snap to 75%. I'll hold Shift selecting those two polygons, and I will snap this again to 75%. Now the fun thing about this is that we can begin selecting each one of these points and polygons and begin adjusting them the way we'd like to. I can lower these eyes here. I can select this point and this point and move them down to create a little bit more of a fox-like shape. Maybe give him a little bit of a pointier nose here. So now we have our low poly mask that looks a little bit like something you could create using origami. I might lower these two just a little bit. This is looking pretty good. And just before we wrap up this tutorial, because now you know pretty much how to use the weld tool. We've used it to create this mask. You know the hotkeys for it. You can also use the weld tool with two separate objects. So let's grab this cube here. I'll make it 100 by 100 by 100. I'll move this off to the side, holding control, I'll duplicate it. I'll make both of these cubes editable. You can actually weld two separate objects together. It'll bring their points together, so if I use the hotkey MQ, with both objects selected, I actually need to select both points first, and then I'll use MQ. And I could weld these together in the center there. You'll notice though that since these are two separate objects, even though both of those points are in one location, they are not welded together as one point. If you wanted these both to be welded together as one point, you would actually need to click on both of these and say connect objects. And it'll connect them as a new object. I'll hide the old objects. This is the new one. Now, once I've done that, I can select these points again, use MQ, and click here and weld them together. Now, this time, if I select the point, you'll see that it really is one point, that I cannot separate these. That is welded as one point. So that's just something to be aware of, that you can weld together two separate objects if you have them selected. The tricky part is that they won't truly be one point unless if you connect them together as one mesh, and that's how you can do it. I'll go ahead and delete those. You can also weld spline points together, and I showed how to do this briefly actually in the tutorial where we were 3D modeling a bat cage. For Halloween, you can weld together various points together. So let's go ahead and click on this point and say we want these two points to be welded together. You can use MQ and we could weld them in the center. And now we have a circle, a kind of more oval shape. You can go ahead and texture your mask. You can make any kind of mask you'd like. It doesn't have to be a fox. And I thought this would be a really fun project. I hope you had fun too, and you learned a lot about the weld tool. It comes in handy while 3D modeling. I use it all the time. It helps you line up points together. And if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. If you'd like to learn more 3D modeling tools inside of Cinema 4D, please hit like and subscribe so that you'll be notified the next time a tutorial comes out. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you next time on Ambient 3D Animations.